Attempt number two. I will resample a big L track. Brilliance of Big L, which is free on archive.org, so I think his full discography is free, so I probably won't have any copyright issues. Also, I would like to stress mention, exclaim, or that I do private lessons. More info, I will set out more info in my in the video description. Hit me up, as I'm doing discount things, as I'm trying to set this up as a kind of a little community. I'm thinking of doing a Patreon later on and whatnot, but I right now my focus is just putting out videos. Okay. And doing private lessons. So the original source thing is a Big L track. The difference being here with the from my recent videos is I'll just use stuff that I normally use. I won't limit myself to stable to stuff. I think I could do, and what I like is the sequences are called spiral in Reaktor. It's visually very nice, and really has some cool capabilities. So what I could do with this, also, I tried several attempts with, like, resampling this in the spirit of the original track, like leaving it as a hip hop thing, but it just takes too much time for it to sound good, as this just sounds incredible as itself. So I'll resample this into something that's probably not even remotely similar to the original one. So what I could do here is I could create a simpler. And drag this in here, slice it, but can I slice it as like, because I have these warp markers here, right? So I could slice the new MIDI tracks warp marker. Okay. Yeah, that's already very good, as the original track is just incredible. So what I'll use is I'll use Reaktor as a sequencer to just trigger these slices. It doesn't matter what key it is in. It will matter. Okay, I'll just fine tune it. Okay, I will take MIDI from... Actually, in this one where the slice thing is, I'll take MIDI from Reaktor 1, make sure that it's put to this, and boom. Okay. Right, so already. So here you have various parameters. And you can change, so you can maybe add in more objects. Kind of scary how good, like how fast, how good and how fast you can go with it. So, right in here with just these basic parameters. you can these numbers here, just they change the right, this is the range of notes that this could affect. So here you can see the notes getting, or the slices getting affected. So I had to manually slice this thing. Right, this already has, this makes pretty good sense. So I could just right. So this is just like a single value, and it's playing a single note, and you can change it if you want. But for this context, maybe you could. You can also make do this like as an unquantized thing. And what's cool is that you have information, like MIDI information, that you can map out to plugins, right? So each time this MIDI note hits, you can also mess around like with the range of the velocity that they're hitting with. And so you can map those out as well with expression control, so it could, like, it sounds cool in context with, right? So you have velocity here, so I could just put in plugins. For example, I could do the always good. I'll quickly just go through this one and maybe find some parameters that sound cool, like cool, like you get controlled. Yeah, for some reason this just stops playing when I disable it. And sky is the limit, baby, here is. Right, I could just map these out here as well. Like this, this. This. Just map them out to a controller. Boom, boom, boom. I don't have a controller connected to, but you can just hear the potential here, right? But it's very similar, very. Stupid how simple the concept is, right? Why am I low pass? Something here, right? It sounds cool low pass as well because it's a good track. But. And you can just map out, mess around, add in different effects. Remix, redo, and so on. Ba, 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 ba. Yeah, this one will be. Was I recording? Yes. Okay, this one will be a shorter one. Finally. thank you for watching.